Streak on Matter. Hey, how we doing? Welcome back to another episode of Treacle Matter, your nostalgic connection, where we take a look at a variety of people, places, and things from the past through a sticky sweet veil of nostalgia, and encourage our viewers to let us know in the comments what makes you nostalgic so we can feature it in a future episode. I'm your host, Joseph Nocera, and yes, this is our fourth and final Christmas special for 2021, which also means it's Christmas Eve. Our nostalgic Christmas person, aside from Jesus, has become the ultimate symbol of the season of giving, Santa Claus. Modern depictions of this jolly spirit are typically of a very round, old man with white hair and a bushy beard. He wears a great red suit with white trim, a hanging cap with a white pom-pom at the end, and holding a bulging sack of toys over his shoulder, he flies across the sky in a sleigh pulled by 8 magical reindeer. He spends the whole year building toys for good girls and boys at his castle and workshop up at the North Pole, and has lots of help from his elf employees. At least I hope he pays them. He delivers presents to all who believe in him on Christmas Eve, and children of all ages wake to find his generous gifts on Christmas morning. He's known for leaving gifts in stockings, sliding down chimneys, and above all, the spirit of giving. Oh, and of course he loves when you leave him milk and cookies. Do you believe in Santa Claus? Our nostalgic Christmas place is more of a state of mind than anything else. Where everyone wants to be this time of year. Home for the holidays. Whether that means packing up the kids and heading to Grandma and Grandpa's house, or hunkering down and staying right where you are, as the song goes, there's no place like home for the holidays. Old nostalgic smells of potpourri, candles, and home cooking filled the air, and we're brought back together with our brothers, sisters, friends, and other family members, sometimes after much too long apart. Where will you be spending Christmas this year? You might say anywhere you celebrate Christmas is home. And our nostalgic Christmas thing is what some say the holidays are all about. Gifts. And in a sense, they're right. Giving gifts is such a beautiful way to show someone you love them. Whether it's making something by hand, writing something lovely in a card, saving up to get someone that special something they were hoping for, or helping a friend or even a stranger in need, this time of year can be a great reminder of how we should always treat our fellow human beings. When you're a kid, you think getting presents is the best. And how can you blame them? Writing that letter to Santa and opening a beautifully wrapped present under the Christmas tree is a nostalgic sensation like no other. But as we grow and truly feel how great it is to give of ourselves, that's when you really feel the magic of Christmas and gift-giving. Aw, man, I'm not crying. You're crying. Yeah, that was really something. And while I take care of this pesky thing in my eye, here's our cozy little Christmas retromercial. Weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful.
Nothing melts away the cold like a delicious hot bowl of Campbell's chicken noodle soup.
Let it snow, let it snow.
Do you remember this Campbell's soup ad from the early 90s? Over 152 years old and known mostly for their canned soup products, through mergers and acquisitions, this company has become one of the largest manufacturers of processed food in the U.S. Pepperidge Farms, Snyder's of Hanover, V8, and Swanson are just a few of the big brands under their umbrella. Chances are pretty good you have something in your pantry produced by these guys. In the 1960s, Andy Warhol famously depicted Campbell's super recognizable red and white cans as art. Anyway, do you have any fond nostalgic memories of Campbell's products? And if you know me or have seen this show, then you know this is one of my favorite segments, Animation Sensation. There's so much good and especially nostalgic animation associated with the holidays, and I know I've already discussed 2 Rankin-Bass specials, but I just can't conclude our last Christmas episode without talking about the Mac Daddy of them all, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. The very first production by Rankin-Bass, the folks involved in the making of this masterpiece had no idea the lasting legacy they were creating. With the painstaking stop-motion animation outsourced to Japan, hardly any of the original puppets and props remain. Based on the song of the same name, we're shown how Rudolph, once shunned for his red nose, saves Christmas and is eventually embraced by his friends, family, and Santa. Told and sung by Burl Ives, who we covered in our first Christmas special, this film includes some classic Christmas songs that have endured over the decades, like Silver and Gold and Holly Jolly Christmas. With lovable characters like Hermie the Elf, Cornelius the Prospector, the Island of Misfit Toys, and even the Abominable Snowman, this film offers nostalgia year after year and a glimpse at a unique form of animation for newer generations. Before we continue, let me tell you about today's sponsor, Crochet by Deal, offering custom handmade wearable items like scarves and hats to adorable amigurumi lovable creatures at affordable prices. Contact Adelia at crochetbydeal@gmail.com and get 10% off when you place your order today. It's a great gift idea for any age and a chance to support a small business. Crochet by Deal, link is in the description. Also, check out all my recent music videos right here on YouTube and my original music on your favorite streaming platforms. Just search Joseph Nocera. It's Joseph with an F. Follow me on Instagram at Joseph Nocera Music, where you'll find even more content and behind-the-scenes looks at what I'm up to. Don't forget to like, share, and comment what makes you nostalgic, and subscribe for more episodes of Treacle Matter. And consider supporting the channel on Patreon. Link is in the description. Thanks so much for watching, and now, back to more Treacle Matter. Yowza, I'm starting to feel like the snowman in our retromercial, just thinking about today's nostalgic knockout. Nicolette Scorsese. If that name doesn't ring a bell, well, it's because aside from being the absolutely steaming temptress in National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation, she really hasn't been in too many more notable productions. A couple movies and TV appearances. She started out as a model, and it's clear to see why. Because of her last name, she is often associated with the director Martin Scorsese, although there's no relation. But since this film is such a hilarious and beloved Christmas classic, she'll forever be that hot chick from Christmas Vacation. We watch as Chevy Chase's character makes an absolute fool of himself in the mall in front of his son, played by the Big Bang Theory actor Johnny Galecki. This scene is cringeworthy, you wanna look away, yet Nicolette makes it very difficult to do so. Then, as Chase is imagining the pool he's hoping to surprise his family with, she appears as a fantasy and takes off her swimsuit. I wonder why she didn't decide to do more acting. If you know anything else about Nicolette Scorsese, let me know in the comments. She's certainly a Christmas nostalgic knockout. Now that was hot. Let's cool off with our monumental moment in music. One of the best known and most commonly sung American songs in the world, and not really a Christmas song, still, let's talk about Jingle Bells. Written by James Lord Pierpont in 1857, the original title is The One Horse Open Sleigh, which makes a lot more sense as a title. It's like how Frank Sinatra's song is known as Fly Me to the Moon, but is really called In Other Words. Anyway, it soon became associated with Christmas as a parlor song, and has been recorded by countless artists ever since recording became a thing around the same time in the late 1800s. It has a simple but catchy melody, making it one of the first taught to children learning an instrument. Its first six notes are all the same. Anyway, have you ever ridden in a one-horse open sleigh? It must be pretty song-worthy. And now, our feature presentation, which is the film that featured our mystery movie quote from last time. Oh man, you just had to know this one. It's from the best Christmas film of all time, 1946's It's a Wonderful Life. I'm one of 10 siblings, and we all know this film by heart and quote it constantly. There's just something about it, plus we've seen it a bazillion times. Starring the incomparable Jimmy Stewart and the beautiful Donna Reed. Similar to Scrooge, this is an equally poignant story about appreciating life. Directed by Frank Capra, the film met unenthusiastic reception upon its release, but after entering public domain and being shown continuously on television in the decades that followed, it finally received the appreciation it so well deserved, and in 1990 was recognized by the National Film Registry for being culturally, historically, and aesthetically significant. It was Jimmy Stewart's first picture after serving in the war, and he was very anxious about making sure he gave a good performance. He was particularly stressed about his passionate kiss with Donna Reed and requested it be the last scene shot. It was, and the scene we see is the first and only take. Wow. If for some reason you're not familiar with this film, please, do us all a favor and see it. It's such a great film. Watch it with some loved ones, maybe even someone who's seen it, and be sure to let us know what you thought. And speaking of It's a Wonderful Life, here's an apropos little mashup for you.
Nice about your brother Harry and Ruth, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, that's all right.
Don't you like her?
Well, of course I like her. She's more vulnerable than a peach.
I mean, who wouldn't love anyone more vulnerable than a peach? Mystery movie quote. Pay attention.
Wait for me. I'm coming too. Oh.
What? Certainly not. This is no business for children.
Are we going to take a cab?
My dear, I don't think you understand. It will be quite dangerous.
Oh, why you? Look, but
young lady, you are most definitely not accompanying us. And that is final.
Any clues, Sherlock? And there it is, our last Christmas episode. I can't wait till next year. I certainly hope you enjoyed today's content. I hope it brought back memories, made you feel nostalgic, or maybe even showed you something new. This has been Treacle Matter, your nostalgic connection. Feel free to answer any of the questions you heard along the way, or let us know what makes you most nostalgic. I'm your host, Joseph Nocera. Thanks so much for watching. Stay tuned for another great episode next time. And hey, Merry Christmas, everybody.